All right, I would like to play first. Oh, I'm gonna keep this hand. It's not the best hand I've ever seen. Could really use a mox, but I think it's still fine. And if my opponent doesn't have like a Graft Digger's Cage or a way to blow up Oath, it's gonna be kind of hard for him to win. This is, you know, my opponent's deck's another deck that has trouble winning without creatures in play. Does not have trouble drawing moxes, apparently, though. Does not likely have a young Pyromancer in hand yet, otherwise you don't lead with Preordain there. My opponent kept one of the two cards. Alright, well, I'm just gonna run out of Oath. I've got two anyway. And if my opponent counters it, so be it. Against a deck that can win without creatures in play, well, first of all, you don't side an Oath. Second of all, I mean, I would be more like, let's say I'm playing against a deck that has less creatures. I would, like Stacks, for example. Stacks, you still run out the Oath because you can just tutor for Orchard, which I can actually do here, by the way. I'm a little more hesitant to just run out the Oath, but given that my opponent is unlikely to be able to assemble a combo kill of any sort here, I like playing it. I mean, my opponent could be playing Delver, Gush Delver, or rather, not playing Delvers, but playing Fast Bonds and Gushes, and be able to empty the Warrens combo me out pretty soon here. But there's a Gush, by the way. I mean, either way, the deck's going to play Gush, but it either plays Fast Bond or Delver. I mean, and the Fast Bond version has like Yawgmoth's Will and Empty the Warrens and stuff. So my opponent looking for answers and now gushing and discarding. So I'm feeling pretty good about this. Oh, that's an Ancestral. Kind of like that, too. All right. I'm not going to Ancestral quite yet. I will, however, get Underground Sea and then Demonic Tutor. And I'm going for a Forbidden Orchard. My opponent may not counter this, but well, if you have a spell synergy, you'll definitely use that. Well, now that my opponent can't Fluster Storm, I'm going to Ancestral. I might hit a Mental Misstep, too. Or a Force of Will. I like forcing here. I'm pretty sure that I want DT to resolve. Let's pitch Thirst for Knowledge. All right, let's just get Forbidden Orchard and hope my opponent doesn't have Graft Digger's Cage. But again, one of the reasons I like not playing Oath main deck is you generally will get a game where your opponent does not side in Graft Digger's Cage. All right, my opponent Ancestral'd. Well, that's some cards. And especially my opponent's playing a deck with Snapcaster Mage, and well, there's a Graft Digger's Cage. Well, that sucks. Kind of wish I had not fought over that or DT'd for Force, but hey, what can you do? It's pass. I can still get Fluster Storm regardless, and the deck doesn't play drain, so playing Foff into one blue is the same as playing into all open mana. I don't actually have a way to get rid of Cage here, which is kind of annoying. Let's not Foff this instant, I don't think. Ooh, Sensei's top, I do like. All right, and let's play a Scalding Tarn and then pass. Kind of feeling like this deck wouldn't mind maybe a Nature's Claim in the sideboard for situations like this. I just don't like having Steel Sabotage in against decks like this. All right, I'm gonna have to win slightly harder way this time, but that's okay. This is bad enough that I'm just gonna crack a fetch land here. And because I sided out Steel Sabotage, I do not have a way to. Did I leave the Snapcaster Mages in? Well, that was horrendous. I'm glad I didn't Oath, I guess, and I didn't bring the Gristlebrand. Well then, well, Snapcaster doesn't do much here either. Well, I would have been in for a rude surprise had I done that. So how am I winning this game? Vault Key or Jace, I suppose, and I still have a Tezzeret in. All right, well. Yeah, this is. Sometimes when you make videos, you do not always do things correctly. Let's just put it that way. I like this. All right, let's just draw Mana Drain. Just draw for the turn. Let's play the Forbidden Orchard. I don't think there's a harm in playing it, though I will not be using it anytime soon here. And opponent's in there. Delver of Secrets. So opponent does have Delvers. All right. Delver is, I think, fine. Let's Foff in response, I guess. Is that good? Looks like I'm casting Force of Will right now, but yeah, I think that's actually fine. I don't really want to fight over this. And with a Sensei's top out, I'm not super concerned about resolving the Foff. Alright, well, Pyroblast will do it, I suppose. And That's fine. I think I'm going to be able to find a way to win before Delver gets me here. Let's top. Hitting Time Walk, Oath, Skull, and Tarns. All right, well, I don't really want any of the other cards here. All right. Oh, yeah, I can Oath now if I want. I can Oath to mill. I mean, I want to draw Time Walk that turn. It's actually worth noting that I can just Oath and reveal till I hit a creature, and then that creature doesn't come into play. All right, so let's, now that Time Walk resolved, let's cast, or let's use top. Alright, nonsense. Let's crack Misty. How many more fetchable lands do I have? 3? Alright, not a ton, but it's enough to get the job done, I would imagine. Yawgmoth's Will. I like that. Alright. Oh, no, never mind. I do not like that, because there's a Grafdigger's Cage in play. Haha. Alright, well, now I'm taking my Time Walk turn. Now I actually think I do Oath. It just mills a bunch of cards. But that's fine, I still have the 2 Snapcasters. Obviously, if I mill all my win conditions, that's bad, but I don't think I can afford just to sit here. I did not mill Time Vault. I milled a bunch of nonsense, actually, so. Oh, classic Oath Snapcaster. It actually looks like I'm trying to do this on purpose. Oh, but it leaves the Snapcaster on top? I did not know that, otherwise I would have set a stop on my upkeep to top with. Well, let's top anyway. Interesting. Snapcaster Mage, Vampiric Tutor, Black Lotus. I guess I don't hate Vampiric Tutor. Alright, let's pass the turn. If my opponent misses on Delver, I'm just going to play Snapcaster to block. And I guess I'm trying to win the game with Tezzeret here. And or the last Snapcaster attacking for lethal. Alright, opponent missed on Delver, which is nice. Could vamp. Could also just, again, instead of stopping my upkeep. Alright, let's play Snapcaster. Again, not fighting over this, but hoping my opponent does. Alright. Snapcastering Mana Drain. Just to hopefully scare my opponent off from casting spells here. I guess Snapcaster's getting bolted. Is that the joke? Alright. Well, I can't cast Mana Drain, so I'm going to take the damage. And now instead of vamping, I could draw vamp, or I could just mill Lotus and vamp. I think that's actually better. I don't really want to waste a draw step, so. Let's untap. I now have stop set on my upkeep. So let's Oath for 2. That's weird the order it shows them in there, but okay. And then go ahead and top. So now I can actually just keep milling for 2 every turn if I really want to, I suppose. Well, let's draw Ponder. And do I want to wait? Well, let's just look at my top 3. See what the top 3 I look at from Ponder. If the third card is good, I could end up getting that one here. I actually think I'm in trouble this game, because my opponent hasn't gone through that many counterspells, and alright, well, I don't want either of those, so I'm just going to pass and mill, again, mill for 2, and hope this drain wins me the game. I think it's going to be tough. Opponent's got, I don't really want to stop my opponent's upkeep. Alright. Opponent revealed Ponder. Don't love that. Well, I'm not fighting over that. Basically, I think my opponent's got too many disruption spells for me to actually assemble enough cards to win the game with, but I don't really think there's a way around that. Let's see. And my opponent chose to not shuffle. Alright. We'll hit a land at least. Things were looking a lot better when that Grafdigger's Cage was not in play. Though, well, again, I guess I would have oathed into nothing, so there we are. Alright, let's draw. It's Oath, mill for 2, and then top. Let's see what we draw. Toxic Deluge. Suppose it's a reasonable enough draw. Let's cast Toxic Deluge. I don't think it's going to work, but oh, it's additional cost. Gross. All right, whatever. I'd even rather pay 2 life to have my opponent counter it here. I could actually use the drain here just to use my counterspell while I still have the mana to do that. Alright, I guess that's fine. The more time I have, I think the better, because I do have actual win conditions in my deck. So my opponent only wanted the one card, and I think it was the land. Weird. Because my opponent shuffled away the other two cards with Misty Rainforest, but also played a Misty after not playing a land for a few turns, so it would appear that that was a land? Ah, I see. Yet another Delver, so here's that. Let's go ahead and top. I actually like Mental Misstep. I think I'm just going to draw Mental Misstep. I'm also slightly running out of time to assemble all these things, because I'm getting to kind of low on life. Let's not use the ability. Let's draw. Let us top. Alright, I think I'm just going to ponder now to shuffle. And hopefully, yes, let's shuffle. Let's draw something good. Well, that's a shuffle, I guess, at least. Do I have any lands left to get? I guess I have another island. Because I did not mill it. I'm just looking at my graveyard to make sure I didn't mill it. I don't have any green spells, so I'll just tap the drop. See if the old Snapcaster's there again. No, but another Mental Misstep, which, again, counters Pyroblast, which is the reason I like it. I think I'm actually still probably going to Scalding Tarn away, just because opponent's beating me down here. I guess if Delver doesn't flip, I could potentially wait an extra turn. But since when does Delver not flip? Since never. Ooh, and there's a Force of Will. Yeah, I'm not winning this game. We're going to be 1-1 in a second here. And the funny thing is, even though I forgot to sideing Gristlebrand, if Snapcasters were Gristlebrands, I would still have lost. I mean, I guess I could hardcast Gristlebrand, but it would have just gotten countered. Alright, so I'm going to crack Scalding Tarn. I can't afford to draw Mental Misstep, especially since my opponent's got Force of Will, which would do the trick. Bolting me? Let's Mental Misstep that. I don't think this is going to work out. My top card's Mental Misstep, though, so I can always just tap top to draw a card if I really want to. How many lightning bolts is my opponent playing? If I'm getting bolted twice here. Alright, well, bolt resolves. Mental Misstep. Let's see, is my opponent casting a Mental Misstep here? Or is my opponent casting a Pyroblast? My opponent's casting the Force of Will. Alright, well, I'll mana drain the Force of Will. I mean, this counter war is for everything, I suppose. Probably gonna get Flusterstorm now, but I think that's fine. I'll just let everything resolve except the Lightning Bolt, and then tap the top. I suppose I'm dead next turn to the Delver anyway, so I can just use Orchard just to verify that my top card was in fact what I want it to be. So, what is my one card that I can draw to win this game? I don't know if there is one, in fact. Well, let's see. Alright. You get Flusterstorm trigger going there. I guess if my top card is Jace, then giving my opponent an Orchard token is very bad for me. I did put Mental Misstep on top, so I think I can just draw. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's the one on top. If I mess that up, then I do die. And I am shuffling away my top here with the Scalding Tarn, unfortunately. Alright, opponent trying to put all the Flusterstorm copies in the appropriate places, which is annoying. I will admit that. Alright, so a bunch on Mental Misstep. Just a couple. Alright, well, that's fine. Mana drained countered. Mana misstep countered. And then all these things clear. And then I tap top to draw a card. And then it is the Mental Misstep. And then I pay two life, because I still think paying two life is better. Alright. And then unfortunately I use a Scalding Tarn. And so what is my one draw? I guess Jace into Vault Key. It's good to have outs though. I mean, I do have 10 cards in my deck, so I have a 1 in 10 chance of drawing Jace. Let's go ahead and not use Oath. And there's the key, but no vault to be found. Well, all right. Well, got Grafdigger's Cage pretty heavily there.